is the future of the accounting profession? Or rather, what is the future of accounting with AI? This has been quite the topic over the last few years, especially as we're looking at the types of jobs that AI or artificial intelligence could potentially take over. And the accounting professional is one that has been looked at. So if you're a qualified accountant and you're wanting to be an accountant and you're worried about the future of accounting and the accounting profession, I have some thoughts on this and I would like to go through that today with you. I focus on startups and scale-ups, so I will be thinking about that industry. My name's Alysha Randall. I run Financial Leadership Fundamentals and I train new and aspiring finance leaders within startups and scale-ups. So if that sounds like you, then please do hit subscribe. I also have this book coming out in a couple of weeks. So if you're interested in getting on the waiting list for this, as I do have loads of specials and competitions on the launch date, then please do click on the link below. But in this video, I do just want to focus on whether we think that robots are going to take over our job. What is the future of accounting? So post ChatGPT, particularly, there was loads of discussion on whether AI is going to replace our jobs or not. So if we think about the changes, or if I think about the changes, particularly in accounting software over the last 5 years, there is definitely going to be a lot of changes in our role. And as part of that, we do need to ensure that we grow and learn with these changing times. So I don't know if you've seen, this is a quote, I don't even know who made this quote, but it's a quote that's been said repeatedly. And it's not AI that's going to take over your job. It's people that are using AI that's going to take over your job. Now, I think there's an element of truth in that within the accounting role, but there is going to be quite a bit of changes as well. I think the accounting profession and the accounting role is going to be around for a very long time. It's just going to look different. So in the future of jobs, in a detailed report created by the World Economic Forum, you can see here in a snapshot that the traditional accounting role today will significantly reduce in demand as we're heading into 2025, largely due to the improvement of technologies. So this is a figure on the top 20 job roles increasing and decreasing in demand across industries. And you can see I've highlighted here ones that are relevant in the accounting world. So as this world, you know, becomes more digital, the accounting also must evolve to really keep up with these changes. So the way that it's going to change is that traditional roles and responsibility of accountants are really going to be disrupted by automation, artificial intelligence, and machine learning. And this has led to concerns about the future of accounting and whether this profession will remain in years to come. So I agree that current roles of some roles of the financial departments are going to be disrupted significantly. However, as I said at the top, I really don't believe that the role of the finance department is going to disappear. And actually, I think it's going to expand. And I have seen those changes happen already. So in my blog post, in my YouTube channel, in my book, I really write about how finance leaders can add value to the business, become more relevant, and I have loads of articles and videos on this topic. So if you want, you can just click on the playlist below specifically on leadership and how you can add value and, you know, consume to your heart's content. So the management accounts is a perfect example of how the accounting role has changed already and will continue to change. So I'm very passionate about teaching new finance leaders how to add value. And I go through this in detail in the advanced management accounts course. But in here, it's a perfect example of the changes. So instead of focusing on quicker and more accurate, technically accurate management accounts like we did 5, 10 or longer years ago, this course and my teaching and the way that we should be thinking about the future of the accounting profession is that it's mainly focused on how we show insight, how to be interesting, how to improve commercial and business decisions, how the business can reach its goals, and how you can help the business to get there. So this is the area whereby accountants will spend much more time and should continue to expand their knowledge and upskill to be more comfortable in this area. So junior roles of data entry, repetitive tasks, they are absolutely going to dissolve. They already have at some point. So instead of doing these tasks, junior accountants can work with software, robots, AI, and manage these tools. They'll set the rules for these tools, work within them, look for anomalies, and really spend time liaising with the business and dealing with exceptions. So again, if we look at the World Economic Forum report, the types of tasks that will be primarily driven by humans rather than bots include these value-adding activities. So it's critical thinking, problem solving, self-management, working with people, communication, all those kinds of tasks is what the more junior and senior accountants will be spending their time on. So rather than looking at a general ledger, because you're creating the general ledger as far as putting in all the data, putting it in the right area, it's more critical thinking. So it's quite a different skill set, and you still need to understand the accounting general ledger. You still need to, all the technical skills is worthwhile because it's hard to spot these things without it. But the focus will be more on those tasks rather than the transactional. So nearly all of the top 15 tasks a water finance leader should either have or learning to develop so they can really impact the business in a positive way. So despite the potential for automation and other technologies to disrupt the accounting profession, the outlook of the industry then really remains positive because the demand for the skilled accountants is expected to remain strong, particularly in the industry and within the business. And I find that that will be very critical, particularly with startups and scale-ups, where there is so much pressure to reach their goals so that they can fundraise, so that they can become profitable and all those different things. So while there are many opportunities for accountants in the future, there are also several challenges to consider. And the main one is to stay up to date with these emerging technologies. We can't really bury our head in the sand and pretend this isn't happening. It is happening. Accountants can also be very reliant on Excel, and still are. I'm totally guilty of that. So while Excel is amazing and, you know, has been over the last decade, it really is time to think about how you can replace all of your Excel tasks with different software. So yes, there are massive changes coming to the accounting profession, but ultimately it's not going to replace the accounting profession. Instead, we just need to move with the times. We need to lean into different skill sets and really demonstrate our value the way that I'm already teaching how to do it. It's that thinking critically, thinking more strategically, thinking long-term and adding value. So the finance manager role that we have today is already a consolidation of lots of the more data entry roles. We have already seen a consolidation at that kind of financial operational level, and that will probably continue. You know, the management account output of just putting everything together, you know, and going through the motions, that part of the role will probably continue consolidating as we get more automations, as we get more software, and as we get cleverer with it. And I don't think that's a bad thing. There's not too many accountants out there that like just going through the motions and ticking off a task list. Instead, we'll spend more time doing that value-adding piece. The challenge we have as a profession as a whole is, because we haven't done it before, there will be a gap where we have to work out how you train up from that junior to that leadership role. There is quite a big learning gap between one to the other. And what I haven't worked out yet, and it's something I'm quite interested in looking at, is when you finish a degree and then you do your qualification, what does your role look like at that more junior level? And having that foundation so that you can be quite strategic, I think that's going to be an interesting learning, and we will see how that goes. But I really believe that the accounting profession is here to stay. It's just going to be different than what it is today. Again, I am focusing very much on startup scale-ups and in industry. This is not talking about accounting firms. Yeah. That's quite different. I have seen actually accounting firms, particularly the smaller ones, really pivoting towards more advisory roles rather than just completing your tax return. And I think that transition is going to continue, that more transactional tax return, financial statements, doing your payroll, those kind of tasks will become more and more automated, and again, will continue consolidating as we have already seen, but that advisory side of things will probably explode. If I think about my role as a CFO, as a fractional CFO, and I think about my role when I was in industry as a finance director, there were so many things that I wanted to do that would take time, like the analysis, like the strategy side, like the long-term planning. And a lot of time I didn't get time to do those things because we were spending so much time fighting fires, financial operations, and these kind of things. And again, this is what I talk about, you know, prioritizing, finding the time to be able to do these things. And so I think it's quite exciting that all of those more mundane tasks will continue to be more automated so that we have more time and more brain space to do the more interesting, the more thinking type of tasks. So I, you know, like a lot of people, when I first started seeing these changes and what artificial intelligence could do, I was a bit scared. But as I've looked into it more and researched more, actually I've flipped and I'm now actually more excited about the future of the role. And so hopefully you can see that as well, particularly if you're nervous about it. Speaking of technology, I do update a finance tech stack recommendations regularly. So I'll leave a link below, above and below, for the finance tech stack so you can check that out. That's for existing software. Again, thinking about startups and scale-ups who don't have huge budgets to spend on software every single month. One thing I actually didn't mention, and I'll quickly mention as well, is the accounting profession is also getting more and more demands. A perfect example here is regulation continues expanding, and that generally falls within the accounting profession. And the next one is ESG reporting. So particularly here in Europe, ESG reporting is a big piece of work. It's actually going to be just as big as preparing financial statements. And because it's a requirement and because it's part of the financial statements, it is falling often to the finance function. So this is another perfect example of our roles expanding and the more boring tasks of data entry contracting. So again, I cannot see the accounting profession disappearing in the next 20 years. So hopefully you found that useful. Again, if you're a qualified accountant or not, and you're interested in working in startups and scale-up and interested in being a finance leader in startups and scale-ups, then please do hit subscribe and check all the links that I've left below. That's everything for this week, and I'll see you next week. Cheers.